Hello, welcome back to RevMods Plays Elite Dangerous. Here we are at Danyak Gateway in the Sanuma system, where we left off on the last video. Before we get started, I hope wish you all happy. Hope you all had a happy holidays and a good new year. So here we are, starting fresh in the new year. It's now 33:02 in the game. I've been thinking long and hard over the Christmas and New Year period. I haven't been playing a great deal, but I have been thinking about it, and I think I've been going backwards and forwards about whether to keep on going with the Cobra Mark III that I've got and getting enough money. But I think I am going to go ahead, since we seem to be going down more of the trading route, I'm going to go ahead and buy the Type 6 transport. So we've got enough to buy it if we trade in the Cobra. I can always come back and buy a Cobra again if I need to at some point. So, yeah, I'm still, confirm, there we go. I've hit confirm, we're getting into a Type 6. So there's going to be a lot less fighting, it's going to be more running away if we get interdicted, but hopefully with a larger cargo capacity, we'll be able to make money a bit quicker. Have a quick look around our new cockpit here. There you go. Definitely only the one seat this time. I'm not going to be surprised by a second seat after I've been flying around in it for a few weeks. There we go. So, all right. Let's get into the starport services and into the outfitters. Right, so definitely need that. Right, we can get rid of that small cargo, and we will fit a docking computer in there. If I can find it. Standard docking computer, there you are. So we'll definitely have that. No, I didn't want to exit out of there at all. I'm going to go back in the outfitters, into the internal. Looks like that's the largest fuel tank I can have. I can have bigger cargo racks because I can have up to class 5. Must be in here somewhere. There's a fuel tank. Have I already passed over it? I thought I would have seen it by now. Here we go, cargo racks. Capacity 32. Yeah, because it's 16 at the minute, yep, so we will have definitely one of them. Right, I need the planetary approach, need that, need shell generator. I really want a fuel scoop on here as well. just in case. So what would that leave? So forget rid of, so I've got fuel scoop into there, so that'd leave me with, so I can have another 32 capacity rack there, so that's 64. I can swap a 16 into there, so that'd be what, 64, 72, so that'd be 82. Yeah. Right, so one fuel scoop in there. Can't afford an A4 fuel scoop. We can get an A3, yeah, but if we can get what size is it? It's 4, isn't it? Yeah, so we want a. Now I've come out of it again. I keep pressing the wrong buttons today. Let's have a look. Hold on, right. Yeah, so we're going to have up to a class 4. Right, so let's do it by class. Descend in first then. So we're going to have a B4. That's a lot of money. C4, that's a lot, yeah, that's a lot cheaper. How much was that B4 fuel scoop? It was 715,000. And that's 178. Yeah, so I love that. So right, so we've got fuel scoop on, we've got docking computer on, we've still got a scanner, we've got the planetary approach. So I want a 32 capacity in there. Like that. Confirm that. And then we're gonna have a 16 in there. Right, so that says cargo racks all maxed out for the ones we've got. Right, so next up then, so let's have a look at, in fact no, back, let's do shield generator. Got an E3 on at the minute. Want the best shield generator I can get, obviously, now, because so I can have an A3 and that takes it down. Yeah, I need it though, because like I say, if I get into any combat, this thing certainly isn't going to be fighting. So we'll buy that. Alright, we can sell them, they ain't going to get us a lot, but. Seems to be on the top there, doesn't it? So then we got underneath somewhere and underneath somewhere else at the back, probably. So, not on there. And we'll have a point defence turret. I wouldn't leave us with a lot of money, but okay, yeah. Right, so that'll have to do us for now. So let's just come out of there and go into this side here. Modules. Whoa. We have no power whatsoever. If we turn that off. Even with the point defense of the shield boosted off, we still haven't got any power. That's not good. Right, so we're going to need... And now we won't be able to afford a power plant. So we have a C3 power plant. So let's buy that. Which leaves us with really, really no money. Hey, we can power stuff up now. Right, so let's get the shield booster back up again. That's up to 95. Can we do the point defense as well? 97, yeah. Okay. Alright, fire groups. Basic discovery scanner. There we go. Right, so inventory, nothing in there. And functions. Fire forward at the minute because we haven't got anything on, so right, it doesn't leave us with a great deal of money, but there we go. That leaves us with 34,000 credits to start on this trade run. Hopefully we'll... I'm now pressing the wrong buttons on everything. Right, so let's get the database set up. Sorry, back into outfitters. What's the cargo capacity now? Is cargo capacity is currently 0 tons. That doesn't seem right. 32, 64, 64, 64, 72, 82. Thousand credits. Come out of there. Out of there. We are in the Sanumus system. The Dunyak Gateway. Right, so ignore tobacco, imperial slave and slave ignored, 150 year max hops, just doing 4 hops this time, hopefully. In fact, leave it at 4 hops now because we've spent a bit of time getting this new ship and outfitting it. 82 tons cargo capacity, 34,000. And then, right, let's see if we can find a trade route. Something seems to have come up. Right, so into the starport services, into the commodities market, and the first thing we are looking for is copper. We've She beat. Comes to 80 tons, okay. That's obviously my mass is being its usual helpful self. So, right, so that's 80 tons of copper on board. Let's get into the navigation. Now, we are going to the organ system. Independent system by the looks of it. Oh, we're gonna have to fuel scoop. How about economical route? How about if we go the economical way? Can we? No, we're still. We're still gonna have to fuel scoop at some point. So, 13 jumps. No, no wonder we're gonna have to fuel scoop at some point. Right, so we've got a new ship, we've got this cargo on, we're full of fuel, so let's get on his way. And we are right down the front of the station. To get out the first time without destroying ourselves. Yeah, I'm going. Thank you. Let's get my power sorted out. There we go, first jump in as T6. There's still unexplored things to go and scan. Got warm on that one there. I didn't think we were that close in, but obviously we were. So let's just creep in and have a bit of a fuel scoop on this one here if we can. Top off his tank, and hopefully this should be as good to make us good for the rest of the run. Doesn't look like it's giving us any planetary landings for this run. Just the first time out with a Type 6, so a nice easy run will do us nicely. Now we have to admit there's some pretty long runs that it's got for us here, so we might have to do a fair bit of fuel scooping on some of them. Tank's topped off. Make sure we're locked on for those next. Yep, next destination leg of this run.
Frameshift drive charging.
Going to get really warm here. This seems to get really warm, does this ship? I know we got in close there because we were heading towards the star when we were fuel scooping, but got seriously warm on that one. To his fuel to get us to his destination now. Yep, looks like we have. Don't see any more dotted lines there. Yep, seem to have lost the lock on that then when we went into the map.
Frameshift drive charging.
I haven't got exactly the greatest frameshift drive on this thing, but it certainly ramps up the heat on it as soon as I activate the frameshift drive. So it looks like that'll have to be the first thing that I frameshift drive is going to be the first thing I have to upgrade once I get a bit more cash in the bank.
Charging.
Yeah, might be a touch close on this one.
Warning, taking heat damage.
Yeah, I'm definitely on the ragged edge of disaster every jump this with this thing. Until I start to get some decent bits of kit on it.
Frameshift drive charging.
It seems to roll fast enough, this thing, but it's certainly a lot slower on the pitch up and down. Than the Cobra was. Like I say, but it's not designed for combat. Like I say, if I get into it now, yes, I will be submitting to the interdiction because it saves taking any damage, but I'll just be getting the shields up and boosting out of there. It's obscured by the start, so we'll just have to go over a wee bit.
Fuel scoop.
Clear now because it's allowing us to engage the frame shift. See, the temperature's staying around there, so I must just be when I'm getting in close to the stars, but it's causing me problems with this frame shift drive. I really should fly. I suppose I should really fly away from the stars more often, but it's not causing us any great problems. Again, this jump point is obscured by the start, so we'll just have to
frame shift drive charging.
Seems to yaw pretty well, left and right as well. So it rolls all right, it yaws all right, it's just the pitch up and down that it struggles with a bit.
Charging. Shift drive charging.
At least with these training runs, we get to carry out my primary goal for this game, is to explore the Elite Dangerous universe. So I'm still getting to explore around plenty of these systems. Looks like the next jump is the jump into the destination system of Organ. Right, so we are looking for Pribilov City in this system. There you go. I've really got to start keeping an eye on the scanners now, because I'm a sitting duck basically, because I've got no weapons on at all, and even if I did, they'd only be there for defensive purposes. In fact, I might not even fit any at all, because like I say, I'd only have to mess around and try to retract them again before I could jump out. So I don't think we're going to bother with any weapons whatsoever on this thing. Let's see how the docking computer does with this big fella getting us in here. Getting awfully close in front of us there.
Scan detected.
Been scanned, but we've got nothing illicit on, so that's fine. I can scan away when I've got nothing illicit on. The computer took us in quite nicely there. So then, let's go into see if we can sell any map data. Yep. Just shy 13,000 credits worth of map data sold. Right, let's offload as cargo. Fuel. Must have taken some damage. Getting in tight on those star systems. Right, we're okay for ammo. Just checking the repairs, make sure everything's okay. Yep. Check the contacts. Nothing outstanding. Right, so back into the commodities market, and we are looking for uraninite. Go in the minerals. Let's stock up with that. Next, we're off to Kappa Tuscan A system. Sounds very Mediterranean. Tucanae. Yep. Oh wow. This is a Torval controlled system. Let's just Yeah, this is going to be a long one. How many jumps is this one? 24 jumps. Definitely going to be a couple of refuels on this one. So we're all loaded up. So let's get on our way. Definitely need to upgrade the frameshift drive on this thing as my priority next purchase. Looks like an asp of some sort going out in front of us there. Pull right in front of us, hopefully not stop. That's it, keep going. There we go. Fuel scoop every opportunity I get. We're not slowing down. Oof. Seriously, we're not slowing down that. Yeah, the tanks are full again, but I'm definitely going to have to turn around and fly away from this star a bit before I attempt to jump anywhere. Let's flip her over. Until I'm pointing away from that, then throttle up. It's always scary that when you don't throttle down when you come out of the jump and you're hurtling towards the star.
Frameshift drive charging.
lots of stars this one. Gee, white and yellow, can we fuel scoop off this thing? Yeah, we can. Take on some fuel here. And all we do is just check out the map, see if we can make it all the way. Yep. Nope, it's still a long way off being able to make it. Do seem to have a good fuel scoop though. So. Oh, we're supposed to be jumping to next. Yep. Yeah. Yeah, we'll get a bit warm, but we'll make it all right. Or not. I think we're going to get a bit too warm on this one. Yeah, she'd really have flown away from that star first on that one, I think. That's a lot more hospitable if you fly away from the star a bit before you try to jump after your fuel scoops. So I have to remember to try and do that from now on. Try not to take any more damage. No, we ain't fuel scooping off that thing. I don't believe. No. Yeah, I didn't think you could fuel scoop off them. Charging. Let's keep topping off the tanks wherever I can. Spinning and touch through space there, but everything worked out in the end. We don't get too many of those brown dwarfs on the way through. Seems we can't pick up any fuel from them. See if we can fuel screw off these things. So we definitely know we can't fuel scoop off the purple ones. Can we fuel scoop off the white ones? Scoop up a bit more. No, we would have been. Yeah. No. Can't do it off tea towery stars either then, okay? So the purple ones and the bright white ones we can't fuel scoop off, so we don't want too many of them on this journey. This is why you take on fuel whenever you can. So when you get a couple of systems in a row like this that you can't fuel scoop from, you're not panicking because things are desperate. Now you can start to worry a bit. Yeah, we've still got over half a tank of fuel, so we should be alright. Being able to refuel at the next system would be really nice. Nope. Well, that's a red one. We haven't tried red ones, have we? So. No, we would have been scooping by now. What could have done from that? Things are starting to get a bit dodgy on the fuel front now. And that's not helping. Not even any stations or anything in this system that we can go and fuel up at. Oh dear. Still 11 jumps away from where we're going to.
Frameshift drive charging.
on, be somewhere I can fuel scoop from. You know you want to do, you know you don't want to make me run out of fuel again. Okay, see what the next system brings us. Not good. Right, we're in trouble now. We are officially in trouble. Don't even know if we're going to have enough fuel for the next jump. So I may have screwed myself here. Oh dear. I've got to make sure. Nope. Because if you could scoop off it, I would be by now. I am out of fuel. Right, so I can't jump to there. Can I jump anywhere else? Can I jump to that? Yep, I can make it there. Don't know if it'll make it any better. That's probably where I've just come from. No stations though. Right, I'm desperate now, so I'm going to try and get really in close to this thing. Nope. Oh dear me. Right, I've made a right mess of this. Oh well, the only thing I can do is self-destruct. And see where that's going to leave us. Well, that didn't go spectacularly well, did it? Nowhere near enough to be able to buy this again. Okay. I will be able to buy it back. So, what I might do is give it up a bit of cargo space for a bit of fuel. Not that I've got any money to do it with at the minute. So what I might do is I might get rid of that cargo rack. That 16 cargo rack there, and see about putting another fuel tank in there. Size 4, so I could put a 16 capacity fuel tank in there. No, I don't want to come out of there, I want to stay in there. Module type. Scoops, transfer, cargo racks, shield cell, frameshift drive, here we've got fuel tank, 16. We are going to buy that. Yeah, so we can only carry 64 thing now, but at least we have got twice as much fuel. Put all the fuel on that. Right, so that was an interesting little trip out there. Managed to get myself stuck in a on a run there where I couldn't refuel, so I ended up having to self-destruct. So I'm now back at Pribilov City in the Organ system where we set off on this leg. So I think I'm going to call it a day there for this video. So thank you for joining me on my exploration of the Elite Dangerous universe, and I hope you'll join me again next time when Rev Modes plays Elite Dangerous.